Blog Talk Radio.
Hello.
Hey, welcome to the Goddess Suite.
Hello, what's up? How you doing? How's everybody out there?
Good, good. Feeling good. Just, you know, hanging in there.
Great, great. Well, tonight's topic, due to an overwhelming demand, we want to go with what the listeners want us to talk about. So we had another show scheduled, but due to the viewers wanting to hear our views on what's going on with the Mike Brown shooting and the controversy surrounding it, we'll be discussing that this evening. So just sit back, get your tea together, and listen to this brief introduction from Public Enemy.
All right.
Fight the power.
Fight the power.
Well, you know, tonight's discussion, we're going to be discussing the controversy surrounding the shooting of Mike Brown. And this is taking place in, is it Ferguson County, Missouri? Let's see.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay. All right. So let's get into it, Holistic Al. What do you think about the controversy surrounding the shooting of Mr. Mike Brown? He was on his way to college. Another one of our black brothers being gunned down, unarmed, might we add. Once again, tell us what you think about this.
I just feel like it's very, you know, disheartening and disturbing because being a woman of color and having a male African-American child, you know, it just, it makes you a little fearful, you know, because I feel like when you're raising your sons or your children, you want them to be independent. And you raise them so that they're not fearful. At least that's how, you know, how I raised my son. And I just feel like I don't want to get to a point where he becomes a teen and I'm like, okay, you can't listen to this type of music and you can't dress this way and you can't this and you have to remember this. I just feel like it's just not fair. You know, I just feel like it's totally not fair that these are things I should have to tell my son. I just feel like he should be able to be a young man that enjoys his life instead of having to watch his back, you know? And it just, you know, my heart goes out to the family of Mike Brown and all the other black males that have been, you know, killed unjustly. I mean, it's bad enough when you have black-on-black violence, but then when you have an officer that's supposed to protect and serve, that's your job, but you actually don't do it, then it's sad. It's very sad. And I hope, you know, I hope that justice is served. And I was just telling Mystic Fella that I think I need to take a break from the social media because I'm just starting to see more and more videos pop up, and I just kind of don't want those type of images in my head. I just rather, you know, not put myself in that type of place.
Yeah, and I completely agree, you know. I mean, and you got to remember, too, social media does help instill fear into the public. That's what it's there for as well. It's good for information and those type of things, but one of its main causes is to create panic in people and keep people in fear, just like the TV, you know, and those type of things, just to keep us steadily seeing the images of what we don't want to occur in our reality. You know, we see it on TV all the time. So it's not good to overload yourself with those type of images. You want to kind of keep yourself in a positive state of mind. Stay outside, get outside more, focus your attention on things that you do want out of life. But this is something that's definitely not new to any of us people of color. You know, hearing something like this is definitely not new. But it is sad because, like Holistic Al said, it's these are our children, and to have your children have to grow up in some sort of fear-based society, it's real disheartening, especially when, children are supposed to be living their lives. But to be afraid of the people who are supposed to protect you, that says a lot about our country, and that says a lot about how far we have evolved as a human race. And to me, it's not very far, because if we are being brutal to the people we're supposed to serve, especially someone that's unarmed, I mean, it's so many things that's happening on a daily basis in this world, you're wondering what kind of pill are people taking? Are they smoking something? I mean, because people are spazzing out all over the world, in case you haven't noticed, and doing a lot of things. Now we can say that these things are occurring more and more often, but are they, or they're just some things that we haven't heard of as much on the regular because we have technology to hear this all the time. But either way, it's very disheartening that we're still going through this in 2014, going on 15.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I don't know if people have been following the papers and if they know anything about this hacktivist group called Anonymous, but they have been keeping their eyes on what's going on, the injustices that are going on around the world, and they're definitely making themselves known around these parts and around Ferguson as well, because they have released a photograph and the name of the officer that has done the actual shooting. And they also threatened to release the whole police department information if they are violent to protesters. So I want to get Sister Love's take. I don't know if you've heard anything about that, Sister Love.
Yeah, I've heard about Michael Brown. It's very, like you guys said, it's very, very disheartening. And I have a young son, a black male, and I put in my chapter one, because basically what it seems like is going on right now is a police force. First of all, we're in a police state, okay? They have the right to do whatever they want, it seems like, but they're specifically targeting black children, black male kids. And, you know, this really isn't new, because unfortunately, to be a black male in this country, they always have to worry about the police threatening, harassing, and not protecting, but beating and accosting, you know, them. So, but I think when a lot of people now are using their cell phones, their cameras, and capturing these things, and we're bringing it to light, what we have all known has been happening for decades and decades, okay? And it's not, in no way am I saying this in any way is right. What I'm saying is we have to watch the big picture. What is going on? They're attacking us. They're attacking us. They're attacking our children. They are literally going after us and our children. And it's been going on ever since they killed that boy in Florida. And then another person killed the other boy in Florida at the 7-Eleven. The woman who had that gun because she was trying to protect herself, they put her in jail for shooting a warning shot. She's black. You see what I'm saying? They are trying to get rid of us. They are.
And people better wake up.
And the reason being is because they don't want us to get the power that we are rightly so coming into in this new realm that we're in the new, because in 2012, the world did change. The world did end. The old world and the new world began. Right now, we're in a magnetic field, and people are waking up. People are becoming conscious. People are seeing what's going on. See, when they begin to suppress us and kill us, they suppress our ability to rise, okay? And also, we also need to find out, while they're doing these things to us, what else is going on in this country that they're doing? What is going on in the political arena that they are doing to us? Because when the thing happened with that boy in Florida, who the guy Zimmerman killed, at that same time, Congress was voting to repeal civil rights. At that same time. So they're trying to take our focus off something that they're doing. At the same time, they're trying to kill us off. And we have to really talk to our children, talk to our boys, we have to go back to the 50s and the 40s and talk to our kids about that, about how to deal with them. I mean, I don't even know how to deal with a police force nationwide that will first shoot you. And this didn't just happen in Missouri, it happened in New York as well. And so it's happening all over the country right now. So we just have to somehow find the words to say to our children, male and female, black children, to not get in any type of situation where the police will be near you, called out to you, have to come up to you, have any interaction whatsoever with police force in this country, because they are out to get us. Plain and simple. It's just absolutely terrible. It is horrible that, you know, that we are witnessing this, what our parents and grandparents had to go through. It's happening again. So it's absolutely terrible. It's terrible.
So do you ladies think that this could possibly usher in some sort of race war?
I think possibly it could. It's just, I've never seen so many videos of police civilian violence before. Mm-hmm. And I just watched the video not long ago that was just so disturbing. It was a grandmother. It was an old woman walking with a cane, and I think someone commented that maybe she had a knife in her hand. She probably had Alzheimer's or something. And the police, I mean, she was walking, and he came and he slammed her to the ground, and her head was bleeding, and everybody's like, "What are you doing? Get off of her. Why are you doing?" You know, and then he's calling back up, and I think it was her child. They were going back and forth with the police. I was like, "That's her mother. Why do you think she's not right there?" You know, it was just like, and I'm just screaming at the computer like, "This is not happening." You know,
Especially in a time where police officers and law enforcement, they know that there's going to be somebody standing around with a camera phone. I just don't understand why do people commit the acts that they commit, knowing someone is always watching or taping, or doing these things. So that's what makes me question the sanity of people these days. Like, is it someone turning the knob and just making people go fucking crazy? Because it just seems like people are just going bazonkas all over the goddamn place. Excuse my French, but I don't believe in curse words. So, but anyway, all over the place, people are going crazy. So, I mean, is this something that, can we take it a step further, ladies, and say this is something beyond, beyond our control, something that could be in the hands of the government or the military that's, they're trying to get people to react this way?
It could be. I think it could have something to do with the martial law, you know?
Yeah. It's a police state. Mm-hmm. It is a generally accepted practice right now. It's literally a police state. When they called that thing that happened in Boston, that bombing that I believe was a setup, you know, I think America, they just, that whole thing didn't even make sense, you know, with that, they were, I don't know, some type of race. But anyway, so...
Yeah, the Boston Marathon.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the Boston Marathon. So, but when they activated, you know that in this country, they activated the military on American soil. And that's supposed to be against the law. Oh, they got activated. Active. They were active. A friend of mine is in the military, and he said, yeah, we're active, but we are backing up the Capitol Police or whatever. And I'm like, y'all not back in the Capitol Police. Y'all the freaking military. They were active. So it's a state is something that is going on right now. It's how they're treating the American people. Yep. The military state. Yep. Now, technically, this was in the District of Columbia that I know. I don't know if it went in any places in Maryland. But technically, the District of Columbia is not considered America. It's not considered the United States.
Right.
Well, exactly. Yeah. So maybe because they were activated in the District of Columbia, they got, I don't know. So, but I don't know if they were activated anywhere else. I'm pretty sure they were in Boston. I'm pretty sure. But they were activated in Boston, too. So it's like these little things that they're doing, they're practicing this police state thing that they're doing. And it's not, we as Americans, no matter what color, we need to let the government know that this is unacceptable for us. This is unacceptable. The police should not have this authority or feel as though they can do these things to the people they're supposed to be protecting and serving. This is not, it's not, and then they don't care, they don't care because they're not going to get, there's no consequences for those actions that they do. They can continue to do them. There's no real consequences.
Exactly. Now, and I don't know if you all have watched, oh gosh, there was a movie I was just watching, and I was telling Holistic Gal about where all of this seems all too familiar. It's in the movie. It's a movie that just came out where they have, like, hackers, people that are hacktivists and whatnot. I think it was called Transcendent with Johnny Depp in it. But Transcendence, Lucy, The Purge, you know, people, you need to check these movies out.
Yeah, I saw that. That was a new one that just came out.
Yeah, because these movies are foreshadowing what's about to take place.
Mm-hmm.
I was just reading an article today about they were saying that California is sinking 1 foot every year. It's sinking.
Mm.
And that it's actual water droughts out there. They were advised, they even have water police. They were advising people to stock up on water. And also they have police to drive around and see if you're over-consuming water. I mean, this is where we're getting to, people. So it's real pertinent that you start stocking up on supplies, water, seeds, to grow food. I mean, you know, just to be on the safe side, to be prepared, because you don't know what's up the government's sleeve.
Yeah.
You definitely know something is about to take place, and it's just better to be safe than sorry. Even when we were talking about the Shungite stones to purify water last week on the show, even if you can order you some of those, when we went to the crystal store, they went up in price. And I don't think that's a coincidence, because they were like a dollar. When I got mine, now they're up to $5. And I don't think that's a coincidence. I think that's because something's about to happen with the water supply. So we need to order and get and keep as many on hand, because it can purify dirty water.
Mm-hmm.
It's just a lot of things that's on the horizon that we just want to keep you abreast on, so you'll be aware, and not to put fear in anybody, but to just be cautious and be on the safe side, to keep yourself extra bottles of water and toiletries and whatnot on hand. So in case something does happen, at least in the beginning, you'll be pretty well off.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. In the event, you know?
Yeah. This is crazy. Like, after that, like, I was thinking about moving to Florida, but I said, no, I have a son, a black male. No, I'm not moving down.
Wait a minute, you moved to Florida?
It crossed my mind. But after that stuff that was going on down there with the black boys, I said, no, that's okay.
I know. There's so much. So many things happening everywhere, but don't let it stop you from living, ladies and gentlemen, because remember, we are all here for purpose, for experience, and even if, you know, it's our time to go, be happy, be glad that you're transitioning to something bigger and better. So you still have to keep that mindset.
Yeah.
Right. Michael Brown,
transition so that he can assist from the other side.
Exactly.
So all that transition, now they, you know, in their, you know, when they agreed to come back here, they knew when they were going to leave. So,
it helps. Exactly. It's just that when we're in the midst of being. Yeah, and we're human, so we're going through the human experience. See, when you can move past the human experience, then none of this will even matter to you. But right now, we're still dealing with people who are dealing and living the human experience, so this very much matters to them, what's going on in the news, you know. But I hope one of our purposes is to help people as well as ourselves continue to move past what's in front of us, all these illusions that are taking place in front of us. Instead of us making those our realities, let's try to work on creating our own reality. Stop focusing on all the negatives. Be prepared, yes, but don't let this stuff consume you. What's going on the TV, what's going on the internet, don't let these things consume you.
Yeah, absolutely.
That's right, and if you have to do social media detox, then by all means do it, because I think that's what, because you just don't want to, you know, you get caught up in it, and then that changes your whole energy, and we all know that when you start when you have negativity attracting to you, and that's how you're feeling, you're seeing all this stuff, and you're getting angry, and then you start to attract that stuff, and then bad things start to happen, and you're like, oh my God, why is this happening? But just try not to, you know, let it consume you, and just keep on, you know, living your life. You can send love and light to those in Missouri and pray for peace. And that's about, you know, probably about all we can do right now from here, you know.
Yeah, exactly. I just read something and said they're looting over there, and I'm like, oh, how are we going to get any progress? They looting? It's like, really?
Yeah, I mean, somebody, an unarmed black boy gets shot and you feel like you need to go raid the candy store. I don't understand it.
I don't either. What are you doing with the flat screens? Why are you taking, I don't understand.
Exactly. Somebody else died and family was hurt, not you.
Right.
Let me lace my family with a new flat screen, because on the behalf of a young black man that got killed that was unarmed. I mean, come on, black people. Let's do better than this.
Yeah,
exactly. And we are better than this.
Yes, we are. That's
what we need to realize and instill into, you know, our generation, male and female, that we are better than this and we're bigger than this.
Yeah.
Because we were on top at one point, you know, and somehow, whether it was divine or already written to happen, we ended up on the bottom. So we have to find a way to come together just like other cultures do.
Yeah, exactly.
Just like other cultures.
Yeah, absolutely. Support one another, don't tear each other down, and don't go looting the store because you're upset. That ain't going to help.
Right, and you're tearing down your own neighborhood.
Own neighborhood, which is exactly. Nothing.
Exactly. I heard from this I can't remember who it was, but it was a wise black man that had said, if you want to resolve world peace, the key to resolving world peace is to unite the black race. Once you unite the black race, then everybody else will fall in place. And I really believe that. I really believe that wholeheartedly, that once we get it together, and we unite, because everybody else is already united except us. When we get it together, we can complete that puzzle, and we all can live, and I'm not saying a perfect world, but we can live in a world where the rightful kings, the rightful heirs to the throne can be back on their throne, and things can work in their proper place, in their proper order. The divine masculine and the divine feminine can work in order. But right now, we're not there yet. Will we ever get there? I hope so.
And will it be in our lifetime? Who knows? You know? We don't know if it'll be in our lifetime, but we can just try to train, you know, our generation to try to do that. And that's what we're, you know, that's our whole purpose here at the Goddess Suite. And, you know,
we want to change. If we don't do it in our lifetime, we'll come back and make it happen in another one.
But there you go.
Right.
I don't want to come back.
No.
I'm coming back rich.
Yeah, I know.
Okay. Oh, man. Oh, we got, okay, listeners, we have 1 minute left, and we want to say thank you for joining us tonight. As always, keep the emails coming, and love and light from Holistic Al.
Love and light.
Yes. Thank you all. Thank you for joining us and listening in. Remember, you hold the key to your own reality, and don't let anyone change your purpose. You have the right to do anything in your life.
That's right. Have a blessed weekend, and prayers to Ferguson.
Stay safe. Yes. Send love and light and peace to those that are protesting.
Yes.
Yeah. You know, well, hopefully we have some unity, some type of unity or something that come out of this for our people. Something good to come out of it, hopefully.
It will. We speak it.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Good night.
Good night.
Speak your destiny. Have a blessed night.
Good.